Yeah, actually chat mode inamaanisha tu wase unajua ukiingia kwa flight unaambiwa everybody flight mode.
Yes.
Alafu kila mtu ana T. Everybody wants to do utaki ndege ipate problem.
Yeah.
But ukiingia kwa chat unapata wase ringtone za
zako.
Wengine wana ngoma zingine haziwezi. Unasikia ringtone imelea huko nyuma. Alafu unasikia mwingine.
Yeah.
Muslim madam, sorry to say this.
Ai.
But unapata
tembea pole pole bro.
Waambie ukweli.
Okay, okay, sawa.
Okay, unapata by the way, acha nikuambie kitu moja. Unajua any man wanga attracted by sight.
Oh,
so unapata watumishi wengi ni wanaume.
Okay.
So unapata madam anangoja tu time watu wamekaa kwa watu tu wamengoja. Anaangusha kitu alafu hiyo. Ndio nauliza. Hiyo pia tutaita holy bending ama nini? Juu kuna picha fulani ile trend day fulani. Dem fulani ana worship alafu amepiga selfie.
Oh, like so my position simu.
Manze God jo.
Okay.
Lakini hiyo ni uongo.
Sawa.
Hauwezi worship. Mm. In spirit na tushiona selfie.
Amen. Ah. Zee. Pigeni umsay some love. Eh?
Yes.
Hapo ni chat mode.
Yema.
Okay. Tell us who is Manasseh to introduce kwako.
Okay, Manasseh the slum kid.
Uh-huh.
Is a God fearing kid.
Uh-huh.
It's a father of one.
Hey.
Big up my baby Talia.
Hey, sawa.
Daughter Manze.
Hey, sawa.
So he's also a dancehall artist.
Uh-huh.
A gospel dancehall artist. Mwenye anataka kuinfluence my youth through reggae and dancehall specifically.
Mm.
Yeah, because najua my youth wengi kuna ngoma za hizi worship ziko na message. But ile vibe my youth wanga wanataka ni kitu ina relate nao. Unapata uwezi pata boy ako chini anasikiza maybe our sisters wenye wanaimba worship. But ukimpatia message ya dancehall
anachangamka
nayo but umpei negative vibes unampea positive vibes.
Mm.
That's why mimi nafanya reggae and dancehall.
Wow, that's powerful. A mother?
Yes.
A wife?
Yes.
And and lately the UNHCR Goodwill Ambassador.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you. With
so
God.
Tell us more about that.
More about being a wife.
Yeah, the goodwillness.
Oh, okay. Being Goodwill Ambassador, we just started off serving with UNHCR as a high profile influencer.
Mm-hmm.
And when I got to know about refugees, I was, you know, pretty excited emotionally, especially because they go through a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I think every time, even when you visit a foreign nation, you also feel the tension, but for them, they're not quite welcome in other nations. And so Kenya has embraced quite so many, and they live in Turkana and Dadaab, almost 500,000. Mm-hmm. And those are very many people, very many lives. And 75% of them are women and children, which is something, you know, I'm passionate about because I'm a woman and I have children. And when I sat down with the women, I realized that these are women just like us. And what they've gone through is really painful. It's really hard to imagine that a human being can go through all of that and still be alive and still be thriving. And so I said, you know what, there's something for every one of us, we're required to do something higher, you know, than ourselves. You know, music has been a good platform and is still a good platform for me and opens an opportunity for me to reach more people and tell them that refugees exist.
Yeah.
And there are so many and they need our help. And so that's what I'm doing as an ambassador, talking about refugees and giving their stories. If you follow me on my page, there are lots of stories, you know, I'm giving talking about refugees and their lives, and that they are excellent people, people with brains, people with talent, people with, you know, with dreams just like us to be successful. Yes.